Okay. I just want to talk a little bit of Range 4. Everybody knows it, I guess. Everybody has seen it. Everybody loves it. I saw Range 4, and actually, I see that code often, and actually all the objects, right? So it's really bad. Don't do that. If you ever see that code, rather replace it by something like that. If you insist by that, fine. Right, this is the way I would write it. It's const in the right place. If something actually changes things, you just put a reference on. That's fine as well. And then there's in theory, the range may produce R values, in which case you may want to have something like that. And then I see people, when they have came to that, to do that. This is really bad. What you do over here is you basically, again, accidentally all the objects. You basically destroy everything. This is like trampling on kittens, right? You don't do that. Don't trample on kittens. So basically, autoref never is an R-value reference, pretty much. It is, it may be an R-value reference, but you don't know. It is actually something called a forwarding reference. So just quickly, so that people understand what that is, forwarding reference happens also not just with auto, but also if you have a T-ref and T is deduced, it's a forwarding reference. These guys behave kind of funny. If I have a mutable L value and I bind it to an R value reference, I could have written the declaration as well as int-ref. So it may be actually an int-ref. And actually, if you try to move these guys, you actually destroy the guy you probably want to keep. For int, it doesn't matter, but if it had been a string, it would be bad. Likewise, if I have a constant and bind that to an autoref, I could as well have written in constref. So it's, again, an L value. And then the other case is, over here we actually have a temporary, so it actually deduces a temporary, and it's fine. So that's equivalent to kind of that. And this guy could have been moved. Okay, now a little bit, something which people may not be aware of. There's actually an upcoming change in C++ 17, which I'm actually personally very excited about, and that is, this is how range-based 4 is defined in the standard. Like these blue and white blobs are basically verbatim replaced in the code, and then there's a little bit of scaffolding put around. The thing which is kind of awkward in that is this yellow stuff over here. Auto IT equals begin and R, and end of is end of R. The thing which is bad is it makes the begin and the end the same type. And C++ 17 will change that to basically do that instead. It's a really small change, right? Auto, just as an extra auto. So the begin and the end can be different types, which effectively means the begin can be an iterator and the end could be a sentinel. So you can actually do sentinel stuff and you don't have to play around with something like, oh, am I at the end? Am I at the end? Are we both at the end kind of logic. All right, that's pretty much all I wanted to talk about, so thank you very much.